girls ride around the Bentley coupe. Got no needs, she got me buying her them Bentley shoes. All we do is shop until we drop. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today we are doing a little quick get ready with me makeup tutorial. I'm getting ready to head out and I thought that I would record really quickly and share with you guys some of my favorite makeup products. So I'm gonna go ahead and we're gonna get into the look. So I've already prepped my skin and everything. So I'm gonna go ahead and start with my eyebrows. For my brows, I use the Dior Brow Show. This is like the best. I honestly stopped using the Anastasia brow pencil because it was ripping my hairs out. So I had to switch it up. But I haven't had this one, any issues with this pencil. I've been using it for about 2 years. So yeah, I highly recommend if you have not tried it, try it. I think you'll really like it. I don't really do anything too major. I kind of just follow like my natural shape and I already went under with a little bit of concealer stuff. But yeah, have you, any of you guys had that same issue with the Anastasia brow pencil with your like hair coming out? Because I think the pencil is just too like, I think it's like too dry, because like my junk was like popping off. Like these, when I would go get my brow, I would go get my brows done, they would like struggle because the little tail part was like gone. I used the Anastasia brow pomade. I normally do not wear eyeshadow. 90% of the time I just throw some bronzer on there and I go. But today I think I kind of want to do a little eyeshadow look for you guys. So I'll do something quick. I've already like concealed my eyelids and everything, so that's done. And then I go in with my favorite bronzer. What is this called? The Fenty bronzer. I love this stuff. I used the shade Coconutty. I have Mocha Mommy too, but Mocha Mommy is a little too red for me. So yeah. And I just go in my crease with this a little bit. Doing my makeup in the like camera is so weird. Like I haven't done this in so long, so it feels so awkward because I'm trying to like look at myself in the mirror and look at myself in the camera, so it's not all weird. But yeah, work with me y'all, I'm gonna get this down. I think I'm gonna do gold. I do have a really tiny eyes, so I tend to like to use things that kind of like brighten my eye and open it up, because if I do like a dark smoky eye, which I could do a smoky eye with like browns, but like blacks, no man. This is the Jackie Aina palette in Anastasia. This eyeshadow palette is so old, I pray to God like it's not like expired, who knows, I don't know. But yeah, so I'm going in with a little bit of that kind of like on my crease. I have to be honest, like eyes is literally my least favorite thing to do. Like this is why I normally don't wear eyeshadow. But I was like, let me do something cute for y'all. All right, so then I'm gonna go ahead and go in with a little bit of the gold color. Now the sparkly color, I usually just take a little bit on my finger or on a flat brush, and I just pack a little bit here, like on the center of my eye. I know I'm not doing it like Sir John, but I actually learned that from, I took a class with Sir John, and he was saying like when he does Beyonce's makeup, like he does like the shimmer like in the, like on the inner part of the eyelid, and I feel like it looks so pretty, and I've been doing that ever since. Now granted, I do not do it as good as him, but I do really like the way it looks. So yeah. Y'all, I can't really see what I'm doing, so I pray everything is like coming out right. So yeah, that's pretty much it for the eyes. I'll put on my lashes last. But yeah, now we get to go to my favorite part, which is the skin. So for my foundation, I'm using the NARS Light Reflecting Foundation. This is my favorite foundation right now. I use the shade Macao. If you're taking pictures and you're trying to figure out the right foundation, it's her. It's her. I feel like out of all of my foundations, this is definitely the best for pictures. But a little trick that I do that makes my foundation look a little bit more natural, I like to mix my whatever moisturizer I'm using with my foundation, because one, my skin is sometimes more on the drier side, so I feel like this just makes my skin look a little bit more hydrated, more plump and glowy. So I add a little bit of this moisturizer. This is the one I've been using, and then I just add like a small like drop, just like a small amount with my foundation. And this is also a good way to like make your own tinted moisturizer. I don't know what's up with tinted moisturizers, but it's really hard to find like a good shade, especially for women of color. I don't know like why it's taking so long for companies to get that together with the tinted moisturizers, because usually they come out with like 8 or 9 shades and that's pretty much the extent of it. So if you're having a hard time finding a tinted moisturizer, especially with summer coming up, this is a good trick. I'm gonna go in with this Real Techniques brush. This is the RT200. I got it off of Amazon. Y'all, this is my favorite foundation brush, and it was like $7. It's really, really affordable. So if you're looking for a good foundation brush, I highly recommend. Now, so you guys, I have recently deleted my Instagram. I'm no longer on, well, let me clarify. So I still have my business page, but I don't have my personal page anymore. I did delete my personal Instagram because I don't know, I was just kind of over it. And I just like, I feel like naturally I'm like a creative. I just don't feel like Instagram's like that place for creatives anymore. Like, I feel like they got really money hungry and just trying to like keep up with other platforms like TikTok, YouTube, and everything else, instead of just being themselves and sticking to a you know, photo app or whatever. Like, why am I even posting on here? And with the stupid algorithm, it's like nobody's seeing your content, so it's like, why am I posting? I mean, Instagram was never like a platform that I was like trying to grow on, but if I'm gonna create content and I'm gonna take pictures, like obviously like I want my followers to see it. And I don't have like, I never had a large following or anything like that. But at the same time, I'm just like, I don't know, it just seemed kind of weird. And I'm at that stage in my life where if something's not adding value to me, if I'm not learning, oh shit, I dropped my sponge. But yeah, I'm at that stage in life where if something's not adding value to me, like I don't want to do it anymore. Like, why am I here? And I feel like with Instagram, like it wasn't a place where I was learning anything. And I just didn't feel like even the posts that I did see, like it just didn't inspire me or anything like that. So I was just like, I'm over it. I'm logging out. But to be honest, I'm just like, you know what? I'm just gonna focus on creating content on YouTube, and then in the future, if I see fit, if I see, okay, you know, maybe I do need to get back onto Instagram, then I probably will. But as of now, I'm just like, I'm not feeling the vibes. And I also with Instagram feel like everybody, like granted, I like luxury, I like nice things, like don't get me wrong, I like makeup, I like beauty, I like fashion, I like all of those things. But I feel like with Instagram, it was becoming kind of overwhelming. Like, I don't know, it's just like everybody is just, everybody's just doing the most. And that's how I was feeling. And it got to a point where I did like unfollow a lot of pages that just didn't inspire me or whatnot. But I still felt like, I don't know. I just felt like Instagram wasn't giving what I needed it to give. And I just didn't see the benefit of me continuing to post on there, especially like I said, if nobody's gonna see it. So that is why I left Instagram. Oh, and then the other thing with Instagram, I forgot about this. The other thing with Instagram is that I just felt like Instagram doesn't really have a community like that anymore. It's more so like a rat race. Like everyone's trying to get the most followers, the most views on the reels, all of this stuff. And I just felt like, why? And like I was saying before, I did start unfollowing like a lot of pages and, you know, following more like Christian influencers or more like Christian content, you know, like the pages that post like the Bible verses or motivational content and stuff like that. And even with that, like, I love the content, but it was still like, I don't know. I just felt like Instagram just didn't feel like authentic. And I want to be in a space where it's more of a community, like a positive community where we could like uplift each other, support each other. And granted, YouTube is not perfect or anything like that, but I feel like that's what it was like when I first... Okay, sorry y'all. My camera stopped recording. But yeah, I feel like when I first got on Instagram, like, sorry if I keep looking like all over the place. I'm trying to look in the camera and look at myself in the mirror because that's the only way I can see the way I'm doing my makeup. But yeah, so just bear with me. But yeah, I don't know. Like I said, I think I was saying before my camera cut off, I think I was saying that, oh, when I first got on to Instagram, like, it felt more of like a community, like more of like a support, you know, like people supporting each other and lifting each other up, sharing each other's content. But after a while, it just started to feel like people are just like watching your life but not interacting, and it was just getting weird, and I was just, I'm over it. So, which social media platforms will be like that sometimes, but Instagram was just on another level. I've been blending for 45 minutes. This should be good now. So I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my Too Faced concealer. This is in Butterscotch. Love this. All right, so I'm just blending out my concealer. For my contour, y'all, I usually don't go too crazy with the contour, honestly, but to contour, I usually either use like a darker concealer, or recently I've been using this Rare Beauty like bronzer stick. I do really like the color a lot. I think I use the shade Full of Life. So for my blush, I'm gonna be using Rosé and Brunch. It doesn't give like as much color payoff as I thought it would, but it's good for me because I usually don't really like a loud blush. All right, so next I'm gonna go in with my Sephora Microsmooth powder. Y'all, I love this stuff. This is in shade Ebony. Just go in with a little bit of this. I use the Ardell. I'm sorry, these are not Ardell. I use the Kiss Look So Natural. This is what the actual lash looks like. But for the longest, like, I hated lashes on myself because they just always look too heavy on my eye. It doesn't matter what lash I put on, like 90% of the time I did not like it on me. I usually do like one medium and one short. So I'll do like the medium on the outer corner and then the short like next to it. Baby, I'm struggling with these lashes today. I think it's because I'm like so far from the mirror. Like I can't really see what I'm doing. Okay, we're gonna try it, okay? This third time, we're gonna get it right this time. Right. Normally, it's not this complicated. It's not working out for me, so. Normally, they would have been on by now, but your girl is struggling. Okay, let's try again. This is my fifth time. Yo! All right, y'all, I was able to put on my lashes on this side. I don't know why it was so complicated, but I think, like I said, I couldn't really see my lashes from this angle, so I had to get into the mirror, but yeah. Now I'm just going in with a little bit of mascara. This is the YSL Lash Clash. Love this mascara. This is just a little travel size one that I got from Sephora. I've always wanted to try like lash extensions and I've gone back and forth about it, but I've been kind of afraid, one, because I feel like I'd be that one person that's like allergic to the glue, or two, like sometimes I'm really picky about it because a lot of the girls that I see with the lashes, like they're way too thick and I'm like, no ma'am. So I'm just going in with my mascara. I'm gonna use the Tom Ford highlighter. This is in Reflects Gilt. Love this. This is like my favorite. Now it is a little bit on the pricier side, but it's really worth it because I've had this for like 2 years. I don't know if you're supposed to have it that long, but I'm gonna have it that long because it's pretty expensive. But yeah, I'm gonna go in with a little bit of that on my cheekbones. Just lightly, and then just. And I forgot, okay, last step for the eyes. I totally forgot, okay? This is something I used to do when I worked at MAC, and I just recently started back doing it like maybe like a month or two ago, is insert a gold highlighter, I'm sorry, a gold eyeliner in like your waterline. So I may have to do this off camera because yeah, I'm struggling obviously. It looks so pretty and it kind of gives your eyes like that glowy, like, I don't know. I feel like it gives my eye, it looks like I have like a twinkle in my eye, if that makes any sense. But no, listen, I know it sounds weird, but I promise it does make a difference. Like, I feel like a difference. I feel like it looks really pretty. Like, try it. Don't knock it till you try it. Like, try it. But this is my favorite. This is the Jack Black Intense Therapy. Love this stuff. My lips feel so much better. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and put on my lip. This is the Buxom lip liner, and this is the Power Line in Creamy Chocolate. And then for my lip, I'm gonna be wearing the Gucci Mona Leslie Cameo. This little gold tube. This is the latest lipstick. Y'all, honestly, I don't really buy lipstick like that, to be honest. I usually wear the NYX Butter Lip Glosses. Love those. They're really affordable and they have such pretty colors. Like, I feel like they have the best color. It's so pretty. I gotta swatch it for y'all so y'all can see it. It is like a matte texture, but it's so pretty. I love the shade. It's kind of like a rosy brown. Oh, that's my Bible study quiz. Now that the makeup's done, we're gonna go ahead and put on a little bit of fragrance before we head out. I'm gonna wear the YSL, can you see it? Okay. The YSL Libre Intense Parfum. I think, I don't know, is that how you say it? I don't know. But yeah, it smells really good, so we're gonna put that on. Okay guys, this is the final look. I really like the way it came out. It's just something real quick. I hope you guys enjoyed this mini tutorial. Sorry if I was talking super fast. Let me know if you guys want me to do something like slower, where you guys can like, you know, I can kind of like go into a little bit more detail. But I was trying to hurry up. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.